You get the you have to verify this whether the it's right or not. But since you are not done, you will not verify and your card will be saved. Otherwise, you will be losing your so much of money from your credit card. So this is a wonderful application which is saving our money and keeping us safe, isn't it? So next one is Gmail. Not only Gmail, any mail template you can visualize. In a mail template, you have different sections. You have general section where your inbox mails comes. You have a spam folder where your dirty mails goes. You have promotion folder and you have some more folders are there. So how does mail application determine that this is a spam mail? So what happens? You must have noticed in your emails, number of mails have the subject as "I won the jackpot," lot of exclamation marks, and you have been rewarded so and so dollars. You have it's their emergency, please donate. Lot many congratulations. Such kind of texts are there in the subject line. So those are all considered as a spam words. And what happened here, the mail applications are using text analytics and the text mining, where in the text analytics and this, they use dictionaries. So dictionaries, there is a positive dictionary and there's a negative dictionary. In positive dictionary, all the useful good words are stored, and in the negative dictionary, all the negative words are stored, which are the spam words. They are genuine words are stored in the positive dictionary. So what happens when such mail comes? The number of the words in the negative dictionary exceed the number of genuine words in the positive dictionary, and they crosses the threshold, so the mail get tagged as a spam mail. So that's how you get the spam mail separated, which with the close of your eyes also you can delete it because you don't require those mails. And those mails which we don't want, mails are always making us comfortable to define them as a spam so that our inbox does not get spam. So this is the another. Beside this, there are various application of the data science. I mean, Uber, as Dr. Ramna has also talked about this, number of food vendors, Swiggy, then the Zomato, and other vendors are also using data science in locating the menu and the providing the early services. Even our airlines are also using data science, where they are instantly changing the flight tickets and providing more comfortable journeys to the passengers. So these are all the different applications. So having said about the applications, I will talk about the data science life cycle. This is the place where you will get introduced to some how what to do hands-on kind of thing. We are not doing hands-on here, but I'm just telling you in words which you can visualize, and once you do, you will have this lecture in your mind. So data mining life cycle has different phases. The very first phase is data acquisition. Then next is data pre-processing. Then machine learning algorithm application and pattern evolution and the knowledge presentation. So I'll just talk in a brief about each of this thing phase. So in the data acquisition, what happens? As now we all are very, very clear that the data which is available to us, it is not in one form. It is into the different forms available. So different forms, when I say they are in the different forms available, and they